All right, buddy, got a cut. I'll put another link. He heard me mixing his food. What are you doing, bud? Are you on lockdown? I don't know what happened. He got cut in pasture. I'll put a link to a little one. I thought I was taking a picture of it, and I end up taking like a 3-second video. So I'll upload it, and you can see it. Mr. T, you're not coming out, so don't even come over here acting like you are. Come on, buddy. We'll get you out here. I know. Nice try, Mr. T. He's like, damn. Poor Mr. T. All right, so I'm going to show you this cut. I don't know what he did. Horses get into things. Look at his neck there. Hi, bud. I know. I know. Let me get that out of your eye. So here's his cut. It went from here to here, the shave part. Come here, buddy. Can I get you to turn in the sun? Come on. Come on. Hey. Hey, gotta listen. Good boy. Come on. One more. All right. All right. So there's the stitches. Vet did a nice job. Came from here. I don't want to touch it because I haven't touched it. Comes from here all the way up to here. And then a little cut there. So I don't know what he did. I came out here. Good boy. I know he's such a good boy. I know. Go eat. I taught him how to eat on command. I think I did cover that in another video. Eat, buddy. Good boy. So anyway, if you look in the description, you'll see the link. Things happen with horses. They get cut. I walked the pasture. There was probably 1,000 places that he could have done it. Didn't find any hair. Didn't find any blood. So I don't know what he cut it on. But he was out there playing in the middle of the night or something, and somebody called me and said his throat was cut. So he saw that kick on that belly, those flies underneath there. But anyway, I wanted to just show the stitches, then I'll show you the cut. And things happen. I mean, they heal pretty quick. That's like those stitches are maybe 2 days old. I think this happened Friday, Sunday now. But the vet put him on some antibiotics. So I don't know how people give medicine. If you're out in the middle of nowhere and you don't have a vet, I figured I would show a way to give medicine. What I have in here is just regular old water and a large syringe. He's got to get this 15 of these twice a day for antibiotics for 10 days. Now the vet gave me some bute. I don't like bute. I'm not a big thing. I gave it to him for 2 days only for the swelling. I want my horse to feel pain. Okay, all you women out there who think I hate women and want to hate on me. Rick wants his horse to feel pain. Pain is good. Pain keeps horses from doing things they shouldn't do. I think bute's way overused. Every barn I go to, everybody gives bute. Every horse owner I know gives bute, bute, bute. My horse is limping. My horse don't feel good. My horse has swelling. Bute, bute, bute. I don't like it. I don't think it's good. It causes ulcers. It's not good for the stomach. And it's, you know, it's just not natural. And I think they build up immunity. The more you use it, the less it works. So you end up using more. The more you use, the more damage it causes. Just like any medicine. So I gave bute for a couple days, then I stopped. And I did it only for the swelling, not for the pain. I don't give bute for pain, unless it's cruel and the horse is in, you know, a lot of pain. But if he's in that much pain, I'm going to need more than bute. I wanted him to know his neck was sore. I wanted him to know he had stitches. I wanted him to feel that pain so he wouldn't get out there, start playing, rubbing his neck, itching it. I give him a bunch of bute. He don't feel pain. And then he goes out there on a fence and starts scratching it because it doesn't hurt because he's got bute and he ends up tearing it up. If I don't have bute and he feels pain, when he touches the fence with his neck, it hurts, so he stops. To me, that's common sense. But as one of my viewers said, which I like, common sense is a superpower nowadays, and not very many people have it. So that's why I don't give bute. So let me get on this thing here. I forgot to take this cap off. This is what's called red cell. It's got some molasses in it, and it's rich iron. Of course, buddy's going to go over there. Well, I don't want him to go. I'm going to have to stop this video to go kick his ass. So this is red cell, and it's got like it's got iron, and it's got like maple or flavors. I put it on the grain a little bit. I just give a little bit. I give less than what they say. And again, my horses don't get grain, but maybe. Buddy's been getting it each day because I feel sorry for him. He's a little sick and he's hurting, so I want to make sure he's got good vitamins and everything to fight off any infection. So what I do is I just put a little bit of red cell, and some people will use molasses or whatever, and I'm just going to pour it a little drop in this water here. Oh, shit. Poured a little more than I wanted there. So that's in there, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to shake this up. And it's not betadine, so some knuckleheads, well, I saw Rick feed his horse betadine. It's not betadine, you dummies. It's a vitamin supplement, and it smells good, and the horses like it. And I already know he likes it. Like I said, you can use applesauce or something else your horse likes. And then what I'm going to do is the pills are in the syringe. I got a plunger here. I'm going to suck this water into these pills. I'm going to shake these pills around till they dissolve, till it's liquid. And then it's like a big warmer. And I'm just going to squirt that down Buddy's mouth. And that's how I've been giving it to him. He seems like he likes it okay. He doesn't like it, but he accepts it okay. Each day I do it, it gets a little worse because he kind of knows what to expect. But the red cell kind of helps dilute it and kind of take away the antibiotic taste. I'm sure it tastes like crap. And then I always make sure he eats a little bit before I give him medicine. Just like you shouldn't take medicine on an empty stomach, I don't want my horse taking on an empty stomach. I want something in his belly to absorb it. So I might give him a little bit of game, maybe a cup of grain, half a cup of grain before, and then I'll give him some hay. I'll let him eat about half his hay, then I'll give him his medicine. Then I give him some more grain to wash the taste out of his mouth so he doesn't have all the nasty taste. He'll eat his grain, and then he goes back to eating his hay. That way the medicine has a lot of things to absorb into instead of just his belly. Okay? So that's basically how I do it. I'm sure there's other ways, but if you're out in the middle of nowhere and you don't have a vet, sometimes I get questions that they don't have a vet and they do their own doctoring, so that's how I give medicine. Hope that helps. Buddy, you came back and I didn't have to go beat your butt. So hopefully he didn't tear out his stitches while I was making this video, because he's got to get into something. And again, if you want to see the original cut, it's about 2 seconds. I thought it was a picture. I'll put it in a link and you can check the link. All right, hope that helps. See y'all. Buddy! You're a good boy, except when you cut your neck.